Hey guys, now I'm ready. This morning I accidentally pressed the live button and I totally wasn't ready to go live, but now I am. So I'm here and glad you're here. We are at our house right now playing the What Stinks in the Refrigerator game. Have you ever played this game? I put on my post last night, hey, what if you have something that stinks in the refrigerator, what is it? And I thought I found it. I thought it was mushrooms, so I took them outside. And then this morning, and my refrigerator stinks again. I mean, seriously, you guys, hold on. I've been like pulling out the drawers and everything. If you have something in your refrigerator that stinks, what is it? I think it might be leftovers. I have this soup that's like a week old in there. I don't know, but what do you think yours could be? Some people said cheese. Some people, oh my gosh, especially like a blue cheese, like an old blue cheese. They stink. Or Red Hawk. That's one of our stinkiest cheeses. Anyway, some people said vegetables, onions. So I'm just trying to figure out this game. Good morning, guys. Great to see you. Melissa, I'm glad I made you laugh. So anyway, welcome everybody. We're going to be talking today about memories. This is Julie Hamilton. Welcome to Life Builders, simple tips to build a strong and healthy life on. And before I jump in, I just want to remind you, come next Monday, Laura Vanderkam, the author of 168 Hours, the author of I Know How She Does It. We're talking major, major books on time and women and success. And she was just on Christy Wright's podcast, changed my life. So I she's going to actually agree to be on an interview with me next week, 8:30 Monday, same time, same place as this. And you're going to be so touched by this. It just really released me a lot from guilt and really has kind of, I explain it like my life was kind of looking fuzzy and she kind of just turned the lens to make it a little more clear. So tune in next Monday at 8:30. So let's talk about memories. Hey, Paula, good morning. Paula said hi. So if you followed my Instagram stories last week, you saw that I was dealing with some really hard memories, some really hard and emotional memories. And you know, when we have a memory, the way that our brain works, it's not like a record where we would take it out, we would play it, and it plays the same thing, it plays the same groove every time, and then we could take it out and put it back. Or as in the movie Inside Out, she takes out, you know, the little ball, and she's holding it, and she just puts it back intact. But when the way our brain works, it's not like that. When we take out a memory, we actually change the memory in some interesting ways. And we put it back in, it's never the same as when we took it out. Because memories are so subjective. And that is why, I don't know if you guys have ever had this happen, but my kids will come up, they'll be like, well, you said XYZ, or you said this, and you're like, what? When did I say that? You know, like that was their perception of what you said. And I said the same thing to my mom. I remember as a kid saying, well, you said I could da 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 da. Or like even now I have memories that she doesn't remember it the same way because memories are subjective. You've seen that, or if there's a car accident, you know, people will remember it different ways because of their subjectiveness, the way that they saw it. So we can do that too. And as a matter of fact, in the book Awaken the Giant Within, Tony Robbins has a great section where he teaches you how to actually purposely change memories. But his is like over exaggerated and it's pretty funny. Like you take a memory. Let's say like one of your favorite memories. I picked mine this time in Maui. No, we were at Oahu and Damien and I were on the beach and it started raining. Good morning, Bonnie. This warm rainstorm, we're soaked to the skin. And all of a sudden this massive like end to end rainbow comes out over the water. And you know, the water was like green and aqua. And this the brightest rainbow I've ever seen. It was like one of my favorite memories of my whole life. But you know, he has you go back and alter it. So then you change it to where maybe like the sky's purple and the, you know, sand was green. And then maybe people are kind of cartoonish, or maybe they have speaking a funny voice, you know. And you can use that as well as like memory. He's talking about using it as memories that bring you hurt, how you can go back and make it sort of funny, or you know, just make it comical, or like lighten that memory up. But you know, sometimes we have really hard memories. For me, my Thursday was my daughter's birthday, and it's a pretty tough emotional day for me. If you saw my Instagram stories, you know why. I remember doing a post about this time year last year about my biggest regret, and I will post it in the comments if you want to watch it. I did a video about it, and it has to do with this moment. You know how your body knows through seasons? Like maybe you had something that you went through in a season, and your body knows, like even though you're not thinking about it, your body's kind of reacting. Well, that's how I feel on my daughter's birthday, because my mother-in-law was dying on her birthday, on Livy's birthday. And she'd been dying for a few days, and I was trying to have her quickly. Some of you guys know the story, so I'm just gonna recap it. I was trying to have her quickly so Damien could go say goodbye to his mom. She was in Northern California, but he wouldn't leave. And so my labor was really hard. It was quite traumatic because my body wasn't ready to have her, but I was trying to let him go, and it was just like a big mess. And so it was just, it was tough, tough, tough. And my body remembers that. It was tough emotionally, it was tough physically, it was just a really hard time. So, you know, on Thursday, it's her birthday, and she was actually born on a Thursday. And so my body is kind of like reliving these moments, like these memories are coming up in my head. And it's something I have to kind of deal with every year, you know, because it was really beautiful, some of the things that happened. Like when Livia was born, we sent Amy a picture of her right away, and they printed up and put it right next to her bed, and she opened her eyes and she said, oh, she's so beautiful. So she got to see her actually literally before she died, which is amazing. But you know, I was having a hard time on Thursday. I was in the shower, I was crying, I was feeling a little, you know, I feel a little torn because I'm sad and happy at the same time. And I just had this moment where I just said, God, will you help me to reframe this memory? Like, here's the way that I remember it. Can you help me to see it differently? And so, you know, sometimes we can just do that. Just say, hey, help me. Can you help me reframe this so that I see it differently? I've had, you know, and I'm going to tell you what he showed me, which is so beautiful. But I've had things happen like that where I was a witness in a traumatic accident where somebody lost their life a couple years ago. And the therapy that I did actually was going back to that memory and rethinking about, where was Jesus in this memory? What was he doing to me? How was he helping me in this memory? And so it's interesting how you can go back and look for that. If you have a traumatic memory, you have a difficult memory, I would ask you, one thing you could do is just go back and say, where was Jesus when this was happening? You will most likely see him somewhere in that memory by your side, somewhere giving you strength. But in this particular case, with this situation, with giving birth to Livy and Damien's mom dying at the same time, I was just like, God, help me to see this differently, because I don't know how to see it. I'm just seeing from my perspective. And my perspective was in a really hard place. And he showed me three things. He showed me one. He said, look how much love was in this situation. I never really thought of that before. He said, look at the love of Damien not to leave you. And look at the love of Damien's dad not to leave him. And just even the love of Amy to hang on long enough to see Livy's face. I mean, that's pretty beautiful, isn't it? That's a lot of love. Damien's dad not to leave him. Damien's dad not to leave Amy is what I meant. So look at all the love that was in this situation. That totally changed that for me. And instead of just the sadness, it was like the love that I saw. And then two, God spoke to me. Everybody was where they were supposed to be. Everybody was where they were supposed to be. I was supposed to be giving birth to Livy. Damien's dad was supposed to be comforting Amy in her dying day. Damien was supposed to be with me so that he could help me and help me through, because it was, like I said, it was just a traumatic birth. And he helped me through that. And so everybody was supposed to be. And then he showed me something, one more thing I just want to share with you, because I just want to show you the fullness of what can happen if you ask God to reframe that perspective. I see your comment, and I just saw it. Oh yeah, Tangie said, I never thought about asking God to help me reframe my difficult memories. Good, yes, absolutely. And the third thing he showed me was this, that I never thought of before. It's just like, he just like opened my eyes. It was like, look at the joy that you got, and her name is Olivia Joy. Look at the joy that I brought to this moment that could have been just sadness. Like, there was such an amount of joy that came too. And so instead of just mourning that loss, we also had to counteract that, the joy of something beautiful. So I just share that with you because it changed me and it changed the way that I will approach this day from now on, because it is a difficult day. It's like I always have to, my friend told me a few years ago, it's okay to be sad and happy at the same time. And so I always have to remember that. So it's a hard day, but at the same time, showing me those three things helped me reframe that memory in a way that is going to help me in the future. And I wrote them all down because I'm going to go back to that day in the future on my little journal. So I hope that helps somebody out there. Beauty from ashes. Yes, it's so true. I hope that helps you, somebody, to just think about how you can reframe your memory. Ask God to show you. Ask him to give you a vision. Sometimes that is gonna be the way that we're gonna get healing from our memories, is by seeing them through a different perspective. Christy said, I actually have started doing this without even realizing what I'm doing, looking at the positives through the things that have defined my life. Yes, that's amazing, Christy. I love that. That's so good. Well, I hope you guys have an awesome day. I hope this helps somebody out there. I will see you on Thursday, and I think I'm going to be talking about time under tension. So time under tension, it is an exercise concept that also affects our emotional life. And we'll be talking about that, I hope. So it's gonna make you stronger. But anyway, have an awesome day. I love you. You are blessed and you are favored. I'm just declaring over you favor this week. You're gonna have divine opportunities. You're gonna have breakthroughs. You're gonna have just suddenlies. You're gonna have limitations broken, dreams awakened. You're gonna have favor and blessing and grace on your life this week. And I'm just praying you're gonna walk through the doors that come before you. And may your minds be fierce and your heart strong and your spirit so kind.
Bye.
And look what we got. Look what we got out of that. Huh. All right, Bonnie, love you. Mwah. Oh, good. Jill, that's so great. I'm so happy. Mwah. Love you all. Bye.